Why, hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Back to Basics. I promised myself I wasn't going to do that intro, and I did it anyway. We're going to roll with it. It's fine. I wanted to start out by saying last episode, we went ahead and built this lava pillar in the center of our house. So not the center, but the walkway. I really love the look of it. I think that it really adds a bunch to our house. There's only a couple things that I wanted to do this episode. If you remember last episode, we ran into a sweet underground mine. So we're going to go ahead and explore that. But before that, I think I want to go ahead and make some more stone half slabs because I had a good idea about the farm. And I think we're going to want to make one more crafting table as well, because we may need a crafting table over by the farm. So let's go ahead and jog on over here. Crafting table, where should we put it? Oh, this is perfect. It's like a little pedestal area. Okay, and then all I wanted to do is I just wanted to line this area here with the stone slabs, just like so. And there we go. It looks a little bit more professional. And then this comes over, see, and we can walk over that. Oh, it looks so good now. Okay, so that's all I wanted to do with that. Let's go ahead and run back to the house, put this stone slabs away, these stone slabs away, and let's get back into it. I told you, even last episode when I said I was labeling the chests so that we know what goes in each chest, I still forget what goes in each. This is absolutely ridiculous. I think that's all we're going to take. Let's go ahead and leave the wheat here. No, we're going to take the wheat with us in case we want to breed the cows if we come back to the surface early, because we don't find anything down there. We have our bucket of water. We have a spare pick. We have some wood, but it's not like we're going too far. Nothing else I can really think of that we need before we go down in the shaft, so let's go ahead and do so. Geronimo, I guess. Wee-wah. Awesome. Okay, so where was it? It was over this way, I believe. There's obviously lava here, but we're leaving this here because we may need it for other projects or powering our furnaces, which is an option. But the lava is here. Yeah, we filled this up with dirt. That's right. Okay, so we come down here, and let's go ahead and spread out this water so we can get a better look at what's in here. Ooh, what's up there? Go ahead and set this down. We'll go ahead and get this area done real quick, huh? There we go. Looks great. Okay. Now, you can't forget to light this area up because mobs can spawn with the light of lava, I believe. Or they will, because we're getting rid of the majority of the lava. Oh, we broke a torch. It's okay. Well, that wasn't supposed to go that way, but it did. Let's go ahead and light this up, like I said. And we'll go ahead and pick up as much ore as possible here. This redstone, not super valuable, like I said. We will be doing some redstone tutorial stuff, but not like way too in-depth. That was a mistake, by the way. Digging right below myself, especially this close to lava, was really risky. I'll tell you that right now. You shouldn't do that. I'm a risky guy, though, so don't follow what I do. Bad choice. Okay, so, nice. Oh, come on, let me out of here. Awesome. Let's go ahead and get this iron. Like I said, this is not really what we're looking for. We're on this quest for diamonds, but when are we not? Let's go ahead and check our level. I believe we're at level 11, so we should be perfect for diamond territory. If we are going to run into it, we're kind of in the sweet spot. A little bit higher is usually, quote-unquote, the sweet spot. So, yeah, let's just keep our eyes out. Remember to always look up when you walk around. Okay, I thought I heard something, but we're okay. Hello? Is there something up there? Oh, there is. Awesome. Okay, so let's go ahead and keep an eye out behind us, because we never want to get knocked into lava if a mob spawns there. And we'll go ahead and leave that, because there's no way we're going to walk into this except for that block right there. There we go. And it provides a little bit of natural light, I guess. Boom. See, like this guy. We wouldn't want him. What was he looking at? We wouldn't want him to ruin our day by knocking us in the lava. As you can see, I didn't scroll all the way to my iron sword because I didn't want to have to like look for it as I was scrolling. The axe does the second amount of most damage. I think we can see it. Yeah, 5 attack to 6 attack. It's not huge. I think it's an extra hit when you're fighting a skeleton. But I mean, it was about speed, and we get the extra hit made up for it. It all balanced out really. Okay, so there's some redstone there. Should probably remember that in case we need some more. Go ahead and light this baby up, huh? Hold on a second. Sorry, I had something stuck to my pinky. Annoying. Whoa. This is so awesome. There's a zombie somewhere around here. I heard him groan. Hello? I'm selling death. Oh! Hello? Please no. Last time we ran into one of these guys, he wrecked us. 1, 2, 3. Got him. Nice. Okay. Oh, Jesus. They're coming out of the woodwork. Get out of here. No. Yes. Okay, let's go ahead and light this area up, because apparently this place is known for creepers. Where are they coming from? Come on. Okay, so another speed trick here is you can just do this. That water will go away, and then let me plug this up. Look, there was nowhere they came from. They were just both chilling back in this corner, like, just hang. I think I just killed 2 lovebirds. No! Rest in peace, Mr. and Mrs. Creeps. What should their names be? I like alliteration, so we're going to go with John and Joy. I'm sorry that it came to that. But you saw them. They attacked me first. It's not my fault. I'm not a murderer. Hashtag free Rick. F-R-E-E-R-I-C-K. Free Rick. Okay, I don't think we're going to tell anybody, so we'll be okay. Okay, let's get that iron. Remember to look up. You can always miss a ton of ore if you just like that all the time. Especially diamond. Because diamond likes to get you. Likes to hide in odd places. Oh, that's cool. Okay. We'll leave that torch there. It's okay. Whoa. How much further does this go? We're going to mine as we go because we don't want to just like run out of food and then have to run back. It's good to know that we have this much coal down here. Like, if we ever need coal, we'll know where to get it. We don't have to go looking. Because sometimes it's hard to find. See what I mean? This is why you look at the ceiling. The ceiling always carries extra ores that sometimes you'll miss. Like, you can go back through a cave and you'll find, like, diamonds you didn't see before. And it will drive you insane. You'll be like, how many times have I walked past a piece of diamond that was on the ceiling? Because it must have been an unnatural amount. Okay, let's go ahead and eat up before we go ahead and go further down into the depths of this cave. Nice. Hello? I'm nervous. I think we're gonna go for it. Hello? Is that more natural light from lava? Oh, there's a skeleton. Hello, Mr. Skeleton. Okay, so tricks with skeletons. Always make it so they have to come around a corner if they're moving. Like, so you see how I'm waiting here? So that he doesn't have to drop on us. He has to come chase us. Okay, no, he's not going to do it. It's okay. Yeah, make me look bad in front of everybody. Okay, so what the idea is that usually you want him to come around the corner after you so that you can attack him. Zombies, you want to keep the distance away, obviously, but skeletons, they can snipe you. So you don't want that to go on. So you do the around the corner trick. Go ahead and grab this iron here. One piece of iron, really? Cool. This water went crazy long. Remember, we gotta keep lighting up because we don't want to die and be pushed into lava or whatever. We're gonna get that redstone too. Okay, so hold on, I didn't look at the ceiling when we walked down here. Just double checking. Gotta be safe. Oh. Okay, so it looks like there's a lava pool here. A big one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually dig above the lava pool. Like, so you see how I'm digging out the areas that we can see don't have a block, so you can see there's a block there. Because sometimes you surprise yourself with what you can find. Hint, give me diamonds. Okay, so that's another thing that I need to show you guys. If lava is running and it comes into contact with water, it will make cobblestone. But if water runs onto standing still lava, it becomes obsidian. Just something you should keep in mind. Okay, I'm just gonna be really paranoid and look for diamonds. I believe we're at the right level for it. Yeah, we are. Obviously, we can be a little bit higher, but not finding any. Okay, that's all we'll look. I won't drive us crazy by looking for diamonds too much. Let's go ahead and find our way back out of here. Very awesome cave, though. This just kept going. Oh, we didn't light this up very well. We'll just fill it in. There we go. We didn't light that up well enough either. There's some more iron. Go ahead and get that. And of course, because we didn't find diamonds, we're gonna have to keep looking. I think we're gonna try to stay in the same cave, and find another system. Where was that iron? It's right here, right? We can't reach it. Seriously? 1, 2, 3. That should do it. Nice. I'm gonna just dig this out because we don't want a random pillar of cobble to catch us down here. What else? Anything? Nope. Just gonna go crazy now because we still have not found any awesome diamonds. I was really hoping to do so this episode. That is an absolute bummer. Well, I don't like giving up either. I like to believe, okay? You gotta believe in something. Now, I was told before that gravel pouches mean that there could be diamonds in the area. Like, and they're really easy to get rid of, obviously, because of the torch trick with the gravel, like that. So we'll just go ahead and clear that out. I didn't get it that time. Come on. I'm going to lose my mind here. Okay. Still no diamonds. It's okay, Ricky. We're not going to get mad about it. Because I really wanted to make a portal to the Nether, but it looks like he's going to have to wait. Or we can do the cheap man's portal, but I don't really want to do a cheap man's portal. Cheap man's portal is where you place down the lava, and then you place down water on top of it. You place down lava, you place down water on top of it continuously so that it makes another portal or the shape of another portal out of obsidian. Obviously, the other way is to have diamonds, and then you take those diamonds and you shape them in the shape of another portal. But it doesn't look like we're going to be able to do that right now. No big deal. Let's get to the surface. Let's go ahead and cook our iron. We'll check on our farms. We'll feed our cows. And then we'll see how much time we have left. Wait, it's nighttime. Let's go ahead and grab some Z's here. Oh, the farm is looking really good from over here. Oh, let's take a peek out of here. Oh, yeah. Looks awesome. I like this room. Somebody down in the comment section below also said or suggested that we put some glowstone in here, which is another reason why I wanted to go to the Nether, because that's where you find the glowstone. I think glowstone would look absolutely awesome in this house. So let's go ahead and throw our iron into the furnace here. We're going to need more coal than that. Go ahead and cook this gold as well. What was I going to throw in here? Oh, I'm going to throw glass in this one. What are you doing, torch? You're embarrassing me. Okay, as well as we'll throw this stuff in here. Naturals. Oh, we have a lot of gunpowder now. I think we can go have some fun. Yeah, let's go have some fun. Okay. We'll grab... Oh, we need one more piece of sand. That's okay. What else do we need? We need a piece of redstone. We'll grab one piece of redstone. And we need one of these guys. Yeah. Oh, it's going to be so fun. Okay. This. Just cleaning out the inventory real quick. Anything else we need? No. Let's go over here. We're gonna go harvest our crop, and we're gonna replant, because we need to do this a lot in order to have a thriving farm, so that we can stop living off these stupid melons that we have to go harvest every episode, just so we don't run out. There we go. Now we're replanted. Correct? Yeah. Oh, we got four more. It's another row. And we have a lot of wheat, but before we make the wheat into bread, let's go ahead and swim our boat on over to the cows, make sure they can't breed, and if they can, then we will breed them, and then we will go to the melon farm, we'll make our bread. Oh, it'll be great. But first, let's grab another piece of this. Get out of here. Do not break my boat. Broke my boat all the time. Okay. Hello, cows. Okay, so usually the rule on cows is that if the babies are fully grown, then usually they're ready to breed again. Like, if a baby goes through its whole thing, then it's usually ready to breed. Oh, I don't have the wheat in my hand. Boom. Hello. I'm just going to right-click all the cows now. I'm not going to really select who goes out with who, because it doesn't really matter at this point. Just find somebody and, yeah, make a baby. Nice, five babies from that. That is awesome. That means, well, we have 10 cows in here now? No, that seems like... I don't know. Okay. Go ahead and eat up, and then we'll swim back to our boat because it decided to bail on us again. Whoop. Oh, I took all the redstone. No problem. Okay. Let's go ahead and get our melons. Come to a stop here. Now, I am pre-recording this episode, so I have not seen your guys' suggestion to what we should remove or what we should replace the R with, like over by our house. So yeah, well, I'm still waiting for that. I think we're going to get ahead and try to get rid of that R. And we'll do so. Did I just run on that? No, okay. There should be a crafting bench over here still. Nope. We have a door here. Let's go ahead and throw a crafting table in here, because we always find ourselves looking for one over on this island. And then we will go ahead and make our toy. Okay, I completely made that wrong. I think it's supposed to be the other way around. So we can't do it. It was going to be a really good idea. Okay, so here's what's going to happen. The R will stand and live another day, but we will be back. And when we're back, we will go overboard and take over this whole island. You made me look bad for the last time, R. Last time. Well, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for the build and then the drop. I hope you guys don't feel like I cut you out there. I'm going to do my best to kill some more creepers so we can make ourselves some TNT, if you didn't figure out that was what I was doing. But yeah, thank you so much for watching this episode. If you enjoyed, please remember to hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. If you want to see more episodes, don't be afraid to go back and catch yourself on up to where we are right now. Yeah, keep a smile on your face and have a great day.